I've been using Azure and AWS for 10 years, so I've found some pretty interesting things that I think Azure is better than AWS at. Let's go. So if you want to host a web app or web API, that sort of thing, you might want to use Azure App Service. It's a platform as a service app hosting thing on Azure. I think it's really good. The closest equivalent on AWS is called AWS Elastic Beanstalk, one of their oldest services, but still actually pretty good. However, when you use AWS Elastic Beanstalk, you have to pay for the underlying virtual machines that host your site. So when you pay for a virtual machine, say a T2 medium or something like that, guess how many apps you can run on that virtual machine? One. You can run one. If you need to deploy another app to Elastic Beanstalk, you have to have another virtual machine. Pretty good if you like paying AWS bills. So with Azure, guess how many sites you can put on a single virtual machine? Up to 64, depending on the size of that virtual machine. It scales from the smallest, which is 8, all the way up to 64. So Azure win number one is that you can PaaS host many sites for a single price. You buy an app service plan, and the smallest one is $55 per month, but you can put 8 websites on it. And internet information services will turn those websites on and off as requests come in. With AWS Elastic Beanstalk, you have to pay for the whole virtual machine, and you can only put a single site on each one. So as you put more sites in your system, you need more virtual machines. So next up, let's ask ourselves this following question. Can you run OpenAI's GPT-4 in AWS? And the answer is no, no, you cannot. Amazon SageMaker lets you run things like GPT-2 and other open source stuff. There are some trap things on the AWS marketplace, which are basically virtual machines that let you connect to ChatGPT Plus, which is not in your AWS environment, or Azure ChatGPT. So yeah, it's hidden in the small print. Azure itself has GPT-4 in the environment, in your locked down Azure Microsoft environment. So you can type things like the following. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Yeah? Come on. Subscribe to my channel, ChatGPT. As an AI, I don't have personal social media accounts. Yeah, okay, buddy. Very good. So, Azure win number two is that there is a totally private OpenAI GPT-4, which is pretty useful. It's very good for enterprises that want to keep all of their data within their Microsoft lockdown environment, which happens a lot. AWS doesn't have GPT-4, but does have open source models like Llama in SageMaker, but so does Azure in Azure AI Studio, which might be more your cup of tea. Next up, a database. You might want a database for your app, and that might want to be SQL Server. So for SQL Server, I'd highly recommend Azure SQL on Azure. SQL Server on AWS is in Amazon RDS for a managed solution similar to SQL Azure. But let's look at the pricing. SQL Server on Azure SQL with 250 gigs of storage costs $15 a month for the smallest plan. Pretty good. Amazon RDS for the same amount on a potato virtual machine costs $60 a month. So let's have a look at those pricing pages. At the top here, we can see that it's $15 for that smallest performance tier. The AWS equivalent for 250 gigs on a T2 small, which is a potato, runs at $730 a year, which is pretty pricey. It scales down even further on Azure because Microsoft controls SQL Server, so they can offer things like a basic plan at $5 a month. Happy days for a small app. That's might what you need. So Azure win number three is SQL Server scales down. Really down, really low, which is really useful when you're just getting started. Now consider the scenario where you want to see how much you are paying to use Azure. Here's a screenshot of a billing dashboard in Azure, and as you can see, down here, you can see how much each virtual machine in your environment is costing you in dollars. Exactly. That's pretty good. So the question is, can you do this on AWS? Well, yeah, kind of. There's an option here for AWS Cost Explorer to support hourly and resource level granularity. The problem is they charge you for this. They charge you extra to tell you how much each individual virtual machine will cost you to run, which I personally think is pretty bonkers. And if you want to access this data over an API, you're gonna be looking at, yes, paying more to access it over the API when the Azure billing APIs are totally free to use, although I'm sure there are some rate limits on it. So Azure win number 4 is that you can actually see all of your costs for free. Look at this. I think there is a workaround with tags, but when you're just getting started, nobody bothers, do they? So you have to enable resource level granularity individually in AWS to see individual EC2 virtual machine costs, which costs money by itself. Everybody knows S3 buckets, right? In AWS, Blob storage. Well, let me talk to you about Blob storage in Azure. They call this storage accounts, and you can create a Blob storage container. But what you can do that you cannot do in AWS out of the box is connect to it with SFTP. So here I am with the CyberDuck app, which is pretty good. It's an SFTP app. We can do things like new folder, call this the test folder. And you can see if we hit refresh, we have a folder called test in our Blob storage. And yes, Azure supports folders and directories in Blob storage, which AWS does not. You might think it does based on the user interface, but these aren't actually directories. We can then drag a file over. That's a nice Union Jack. There you go. That's been uploaded. If we go in here, and we can see our Union Jack picture has been uploaded over SFTP, which I think is pretty cool. So, in summary, Azure win number 5 is that Blob stores are much better, I think. You can actually do SFTP. You can support directories and folders, which AWS does not do. Not quite free, you have to turn it on and off. Azure also supports SMB or Samba and NFS straight out of the box. If you want any sort of file network share connectivity in AWS, you're going to have to pay for it even more than that 30 cents an hour. You have to run a storage gateway, which will cost you over twice that at $0.69 per hour. So yeah, if you want network shares on file storage, Blob storage, that sort of thing, I'd recommend Azure.